Yo, what's up? We got some dude in game chat going on here. Let's just see if he's here.
Turn up the lights, young baby.
You there?
Extra bright orange, y'all to see
there?
This. Turn up the lights, young baby.
Hello.
You know what I mean? Want you to see
everything.
Want you to see
all of the lights. Yeah, do the rockets. They shoot off. Oh! Don't get me confused. Alright, class come. That's good. Ooh, let's go. Oh, man, it's got 60 and 19. I'm gonna suck, guys. I'm gonna lose against this guy. Now, I don't really care. If you just really don't want to care, hurry up. Yo guys, you too, but this is kind of getting the bowling that he keeps doing this. Just hurry up, you have 50. Good job.
We are live. It's a Thursday night presentation here on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. We'll also be hearing from our friend Doris Burt from the sideline.
Oh, yes.
The starting fives for our game. Here are tonight's starting lineups. And guys, check out Blake Griffin. What can we expect here?
Well, everybody knows around the league that if you get in Blake Griffin's way when he has a head of steam going, you're going to end up on his poster at some point. So since coming into the league, I think he's become as intimidating a player as we've seen.
I agree. It's just not posterizing people either, Steve, although he does a bunch of that. When he gets a steal and has a free lane to the basket on a breakaway, there's a good chance the crowd's going to see a mini dunk contest from Blake.
Looking back at the last matchup between these two teams, it was the Clippers who were unable to get it done against the Rockets. Here's Redick. James Harden picking up that last basket. Shot clock at 5. Paul kicks to Jordan. Gets it to go. Jordan's got his second bucket.
Boy, he picked him out brilliantly with that feed inside. You know, CP3 did a lot of things, guys, to change the culture of the Clippers, but one that maybe gets overlooked is how much he encourages and modeled talking on defense with this team. If you don't call out a screen or a rotation on his team, he'll call you out about it.
On defense, the Rockets are moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
Well, they heaved up a lot of ill-advised three-pointers in that loss. Guys, they were way too trigger-happy from downtown.
Yeah, and that's not the area on the court where you want to be forcing shots from.
Heck,
you're a great three-point shooter, and you know that, Steve.
Yeah, I mean, it comes and goes, but you can't just rely on that when things aren't going your way.
And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. And we've seen the Clippers turn around over the last few years. It doesn't just happen purely with talent. Although it helps, certainly. But, Steve, a lot of it has to do with the change in the team's mindset.
Yeah, you can load up a team with a bunch of scorers and talented players, but if they aren't playing for each other and motivated to have each other's backs, then it does nothing. And I think Paul has done wonders for just the chemistry and the mindset of this Clippers team.
And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Here in the first quarter with about 2 minutes gone by. Now it's sent it over to Doris Burt, who was able to talk with Kevin McHale.
Kevin, we've talked at length about how they plan to contain this excellent offensive ball club. He said, you know, our opponent changes, but our principles stay relatively constant. It's all about denying the high percentage shots, the layups, free throws, and open three-pointers. If they're hitting contested jump shots, you just have to tip your hat to them. Kevin, a sound strategy.
Okay, Doris, appreciate the report and coach's plan here tonight. A good one, guys.
In theory, yes. I mean, they're up against a team that can put up points in a hurry, so defense has to be a priority. We'll see if they can execute that game plan.
Well, you said it, Steve. I mean, this is an opponent that will test your resolve. You got to stay the course and you can't vacillate much. You're going to have to absorb some body blows if you want to come out on top. They've got themselves in front with some outstanding shooting right off the bat.
Yeah, it's been a clinic at that end of the floor, no question.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
And I thought, guys, they were the beneficiary of what was a lackluster defense being played against them.
I agree with you. I mean, it was really shocking how many free runs to the hoop they got.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Glenn Davis has checked in for Griffin. Green comes in for DeAndre Jordan. And it's Crawford in for J.J. Redick. Now here's Paul, averaging 19 points per contest. Six on the shot clock. And it's out of bounds to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession. As the playoffs near, let's take a look at the Western Conference standings. Taking a look at the Clippers and checking out Houston. They're tied right now. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in, got a piece of it. On offense, here are the Rockets. It's a 12-2 run here, good pace. And it's good. Jones has got his second basket of the night.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
Yeah, they have the defense on the run right now because every pass seems to have a purpose. They're getting great movement, great spacing, and they're really lining them up defensively.
And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for Houston.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
Yeah, and I've noticed also that their quick hands have led to a lot of forced turnovers. They're getting some points in transition as a result.
Tell you what, you've got to give the Houston Rockets a lot of credit, guys. After losing their franchise players to injury and age back in 09, they've managed to rebuild this team without tanking for lottery picks or going all the way to the bottom of the heap. Very impressive.
And here is Lynn after the three-pointer from Jamal Crawford. Jones drives in, and that one's good. Jones has got eight.
Huge advantage for them already.
And as well as they played at both ends so far, this lead might continue to grow.
And for the Rockets, they've been very shrewd acquiring undervalued players, trading for draft picks. Steve Ball in the hopes of swinging big trades for superstars.
Well, and then when they acquired James Harden, they finally got a cornerstone player. Now all of a sudden you throw in Dwight Howard, you've got another foundational player. So all these years of tinkering and trading and moving picks and moving players, it's finally paid off, and now he's got the team he was hoping to put together.
It's Crawford with the drive.
You know, this is an interesting little factoid, fellas. Jamal Crawford is the all-time career leader in four-point play. That's where you get fouled and make the three. There must be an art to it. If there is, he's the master artist.
And now the first timeout called here for the Rockets. Vito Jurkel is checked in for Glenn Davis. Both free throws, good from Crawford.
Well, you can count on him, can't you? He seems to knock down free throws consistently all game long.
Parsons for three, and another three for Houston. And Clark, you mentioned those four-point plays. That may be harder to pull off now with the Reggie Miller rule. Officials will call an offensive foul if you kick out your leg on the shot. Rosie Free used to do it all the time, and hits the defender.
Yeah, that's how Jamal Crawford got a lot of those four-point plays early in his career. But there's a reason that he's able to convert those, and it's because he can create his own shot off the dribble from the three-point line. And so a lot of times defenders are lunging at him because they put on their heels defensively because of his work
off the dribble.
That's a good explanation. They'd love to get more of those, the easiest 2 points possible. And on a fierce finish.
Yeah, and that's exactly how they're going to cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the hoop like that. But with this soft D, they're allowing them to shoot a very high percentage from the field so far.
Yeah, and they're just not offering any resistance, not making anything difficult for them. And they're able to kind of do whatever they want to do.
And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
And that's what's built them this early lead. Deadly shooting from behind the arc.
Yeah, the D better start getting out there on them, Steve, and soon.
Rejected by Beverly. Tries again. And there's Barnes. That's good on the assist by Crawford. 6 points for Barnes.
They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Yeah, they've been the aggressors, Clark, and getting the ball inside into that lane area has been huge for them.
Now, here is Harden. 8 points for him. Pass to Beverly. Fires from deep. And the shot is good. Beverly's got six.
They've made one basket after another since getting this game started, and you wonder, is the blowout in store?
Too early to say.
Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. Rockets ahead, up by 16. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And guys, we've seen the Rockets really take control here.
It was a pretty solid first quarter for this club. They limited their mistakes and really took advantage offensively.
You know what? I like what I've seen from them on the other end, forcing a few giveaways. That's excellent pressure and good activity with the hands.
Taking a look at Los Angeles. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. J.J. Redick is out there with Collison. And it's Granger in at the three spot. Collison dishes to Redick. Just five to shoot. The Clippers need to get off a shot. A baseline J. Griffin's shot is good. Rockets leading by 16. Here's Harden. And he makes good on the layup. Harden's got 10.
I'll tell you what I love about him. His ability to finish even while absorbing contact. He is so strong. Even with defenders hanging all over him. He continues to finish at the basket.
And Steve, he's earned a nickname that's familiar to anybody that's followed basketball, the microwave. There's no slow buildup with him. All he needs is one shot to go down, and it can set him off, turn him into a real scoring machine. He cooks with gas, not electricity.
Back to Granger. Let's go. They get it again. Here's Jordan. Can't cash in from close range.
You know, his finishing ability leaves a lot to be desired, guys. He needs to take it to the basket stronger.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the league.
Los Angeles calls timeout. And Los Angeles with some changes. Crawford comes in for Danny Granger. And Willie Green is subbed in for Darren Collison. Outside, Green.
Help! Help!
Shoots it. And the Clippers miss again.
Well, you know, guys, the Houston fans could be forgiven for not having heard of Umir Asik. When the Rockets signed him as their starting center a season ago, he was a second-round pick out of Turkey in 08, a backup in Chicago, but he's quickly shown himself to be a key piece of this promising young core.
Now a timeout called by Houston. And you have to give the Rockets credit for going after Asha, a player who never averaged more than 15 minutes a game with Chicago, a restricted free agent with the Bulls,
and became a very important part for the Rockets.
Well, they clearly saw something special with Oshik. He's a great rebounder and defender, uses his body, understands angles, and plays that verticality really well as a defensive center.
Very nice pickup of the offensive rebound. And once he gets his hand on it, you know it's going back up and back in.
And here comes Harden, leading the fast break. And he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Second team.
What?
Rockets leading by 21. Beverly, the pass to Garcia. But they get it back. Harden outside. Back to Parsons. The basket drops and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists. Yeah, he's surprised he didn't make that one because he had a pretty clean look at the hoop.
Harden against Crawford. Back to Parsons. Harden outside. The tray. Griffin grabs the board.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
Redick with the bucket.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Houston's gone 5-9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. It's Harden with the drive. Clark, I'm guessing that wasn't the plan for the D on that trip.
And I'm agreeing with you there. Once they opened the lane up for him, that was a little emphasis on that thing.
Take what the defense gives you and then just power it home, right? Why not?
And the Clippers making a change here. And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Lynn kicks to Howard. Here's Beverly. 10 points for him. Takes the lead pass. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. LA has gone 2-4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. And stolen by Parsons. Pass to Howard. Going to remember that one for a while.
I know I will, Kevin. That was special.
Oh, man, that was a circus dunk.
Solid work on the back end of that play.
Yeah, finished hard with two hands on the stuff.
Nothing extravagant about it, but there didn't need to be.
And the Clippers making a change here. Barnes is checked in and taken away by Paul. Takes a three, and that one's good.
You can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Rockets leading by 21. Here's Beverly. And that comes off the assist by Dwight Howard. Beverly's got 12 in the game.
Boy, the drive to the bucket was nice, but how about the finger roll finish? Beautiful.
Paul dishes to Griffin. It's rebounded by Houston.
Well, it's the edge they've had in that area on the glass that's played a big role in this game.
Yeah, they've got some strong guys, Steve, guys that are strong and well put together, and they've used that strength to their advantage down low.
Beverly, the pass to Lynn. Parsons outside. Back to Jones. Second chance shot. Howard kicks to Jones. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. He's gone 2-for-2 at the line so far.
Well, of course, we'd all like to see that free throw percentage improve. I mean, he does not have the touch in the 60s.
And somehow it's become a real struggle at the free throw line. He's lost his way there. I mean, he's not having anywhere near the same success he had there last season.
J.J. Redick's checked in for Jamal Crawford.
What the frick, man?
What a great play to sacrifice his body and take the hit.
Yeah, I thought that was excellent awareness and anticipation to beat him to the spot there.
Gets it to go. And it's 6 points here for Lynn. Paul for three. It's rebounded by Parsons. Parsons got 7 rebounds in the game. Outside, Lynn lets the free fly. No good on that last second attempt there. A dominating first half of basketball, and so far hasn't been close. The Rockets on top, running away with it. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. Welcome back, everyone. We're ready to get going again as this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports continues. Players are topped off with Gatorade, hydrated, and ready to get going again as well. An exceptional performance so far from James Harden.
Play created a lot of opportunities for himself in the first couple of quarters. And tell you what, he was smart with his shot making, too. Really took good ones.
You know, points per shot attempted is really one of the undervalued stats in the game, and it's a real measurement of efficient scoring.
On either wing, Harden and Parsons. Terrence Jones is down low with Howard. And it's Lynn in at the one spot. That's the five to begin the second half for Kevin McHale.
You know, there are very few players in the NBA who can dominate just with their athleticism, but that's what Dwight Howard does. He's not a really skilled guy in terms of passing and shooting, but when he's healthy, there's no one in the NBA who can match him physically in what he does on the defensive end of the floor.
Harden dishes to Lynn, and he uses the glass on the layup. Lynn's got 8 points.
Boy, great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, sure was. He made a beeline for the bucket as soon as they got the ball. Right away, straight to the rim.
And here we go. Harden heading to the hoop. Rips down the breakaway slam.
Boy, they've looked good in the open floor today. That's had a lot to do with their success.
Well, they've been doing the right thing, Steve. Anytime they've had numbers, they've gone straight up court with it right away.
Boom. And Steve, you talked about Howard. I think you can make a case pretty easily that he's the most athletic center in league history. Not just now, but overall in the NBA. When you talk about Clark, you know, his combination of size and explosiveness.
The list is short when you talk about guys of his size with his athleticism, so he clearly is in the conversation. You talk about a 38 to 39-inch vertical and the way he's put together and built. I can't think of another center his size who jumped like that.
Mm-mm. And the Clippers call time here.
Well, it's been a common practice in defending Dwight Howard to employ the hack of Dwight strategy. And for a long time, people have been getting on Howard to improve his free throws. But the league is considering whether or not to eliminate that strategy from the game.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. And stolen by Howard. Then the pass to Jones. From 11 feet away, Howard misses. Now the Clippers moving it up. Paul with the ball. And there's the feed to Reddick. He kicks it to Griffin. Dishes it to Barnes. Paul outside. Just 5 on the clock. Unloads. He feeds it to Reddick. Paul, right side. Over Harden. The shot's good from Paul. Paul's got 4 points this quarter. Mark, you mentioned the league thinking about changing the rules around intentional fouls to prevent forcing poor shooters to the line. You know, the hack of Shaq and the hack of Dwight, all these different terms we use. Steve, what do you think of that?
I'm not a big fan of the intentional foul. You know, we've made so many rule changes in the NBA over the last decade to improve the quality of play. I don't think fans want to sit there and watch a guy shoot free throws 10, 12 straight times down the floor. So it's a rule I would like to see changed.
Outside Griffin.
Yeah, Griffin!
And it comes off the front of the rim.
What was the defense doing there? I mean, he is not the guy to give an open look to, and yet they got away with it.
Offensive rebound. Power. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
At the line for two.
Tell you what, he takes a lot of punishment inside. When Howard gets the ball in deep, defenses are looking to foul him hard because of his difficulties at the free throw line.
And he's a devastating finisher when you let him power it up to throw it down. He's a former dunk contest champ, Steve, so you give him a chance to do that, he'll make you part of his highlight reel.
An 8-rebound advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference. Their interior defense has been dismal.
Yeah, and unfortunately, their offense in the paint hasn't been a whole lot better.
Willie Green's checked in for the Clippers. Griffin kicks to Crawford. There's the dish to Reddick. Pass to Green. There's the three. And that one's good. Green's got five.
The defender there in the neighborhood, but not quite close enough. Good shot.
Green against Harden. Howard. Up and in on the layup.
Well, their plan of attack has been pretty clear to see. I mean, get the ball inside and just take it strong to the hoop. Be dominant in the lane.
Well, the defense has been very slow to adjust. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
Here's Harden. The basket good off the assist.
So, you saw this. I suck. Yeah. Hey, next time, I can do better. We'll be right back.